Hey guys, hope you're doing fine. My name is Aman and in this video, I'm going to tell you about the very basics of CNC programming. Also, I'm going to start a series which includes CNC milling and CNC turning machines. So if you're just a beginner in programming, stay tuned to my videos. CNC machines are the most advanced machine that every industry is using nowadays for high production and precise quality work. So the chances and opportunities in this field is increasing rapidly. So if you're just pursuing CNC programming as a future career, stay tuned to my videos. CNC programming is basically a set of instructions given to a CNC in the language of CNC. So if we wish to run any kind of operation on a CNC, we need to give instructions in the form of G and M codes, and thus the chronological use of these G and M codes lead to the formation of program. And when this program is run on a CNC, will give us the exact operation we need to do. CNC machines can be categorized on the basis of their axis, starting from a 2-axis turning, 3-axis milling, 4 and 5-axis machines, but nowadays even 6-axis machines are also widely used for manufacturing. There are basically three things you need to know about a CNC. The first thing is the operation. It means what kind of different operation we can perform on a CNC. For example, a CNC turning machine can perform different kind of operation like facing, grooving, chamfering, etc. Also, similarly, the milling machine can perform different kind of operation. For example, drilling, tapping, countering, etc. The second thing we need to know about a CNC is its manufacturer, because the control panel and the design of a CNC may vary from one to another. The third and the most important thing we need to know about a CNC is its control system. Different kind of control systems are used on a CNC. For example, Siemens and Fanuc are two very basic control systems. Working on different type of control system may get you in trouble, because there may be a lot of difference from one control system to another, starting from the interface or the coding. CNC programming is just like driving a car. Before you drive a car, you need to have the exact knowledge of the each part you're going to use while driving. Similarly, in a CNC programming, you need to have the exact knowledge of the each code which is being used during a program. The geometric codes are basically responsible for the movement of our tool. For example, if you want to move our tool from position A to position B, you can use G0 or G01. Similarly, the machine codes are responsible for controlling the function of a machine. For example, to start a spindle or to turn the coolant on or off. So these are the basic things we need to know about the G and the M codes. Programming is not always about creating a program, but it's always about creating a program in a more short and a compact way. And also, there are certain things we need to keep in mind while creating a program. We need to program in such a way that our tool life should be maximum and our cycle time should be minimum. After the arrival of CNCs and the future CAD/CAM technology, production has become much more easier and much more fun. Now we can create more tricky parts with easy and simple methods. Thus, the opportunities in this field are increasing rapidly, but only for a skilled programmer. I mean, everyone can create a simple and a basic program, but what you can deliver with your programming skill are gonna stand you tall in the crowd. And once you get through, you can have so much fun while creating different kind of programs. CNC programming demands accurate and precise work with a lot more creativity. So if you are just starting out, I'm going to give you everything you need to know about these programmings, from starting a program to actually performing it on a CNC. So if you want to increase your programming skills as per the need of industry, stay tuned on this channel. And if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. Also, for further queries, you can comment down below. And if you're new, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks a lot.